Then yes, it's going to be a race to the finish. But who's going to pick it off? It's going to be Michael Barnes just in front of Aaron Pegoraro. As the B-Raiders are on their line and race, the number one place, Glenn McDonald. Who's the next one to come through? Just to mix the Oli, you are required. But Brent Hewitt goes through the stutters like they're not there. Fired through by Glenn McDonald. Then we've got Henry Sun, Mr. Richardson. Then we've got Mr. Lesio. Oh, look at him going through the stutters there. It looks like it was Brendan Richardson. Yes, he's dropped back a spot. So it's still Brent Hewitt leading away from Glenn McDonald. These two have really drawn away as they come in through the S's. And right there charging is still Daniel Horlick. But it's still a charge afoot here as Brent Hewitt leads away from Glenn McDonald as they go through. Horlick still charging there. Where's Darren Wendigo? The next one to go through is Chris McAteer. They come up towards the stutters. It's still Brent Hewitt leading away from Glenn. Ooh, hold on to there, McDonald. But as they go down, up through the centre over number three, Daniel Horlick goes through the stutters, followed by Darren Lesio. These two out in front of him. Daniel Horlick. Darren Lesio. Diving hard. There's a number of moves. They go over the double. But there's Mike going every which way as they go through the chicane. The Guy Harvey's really starting to say, come on, Ryan's chasing and catching. But he's doing a fine job out there in front. As he winds now around number 8 and winds up with a flip-flop. He's really being showing a clear pair of heels. He does that jump very nicely as he draws away now and rushes down towards it over number 10. And winds it up now into the S's for the first time. Taking it nice and smoothly. Barton's got a fair catch though. Right there is Andrew Weir. Ben Darcy.
Hey.
What are you doing,
Dickhead? I think the third one is going to go right. That's going to go up. Here we go, 948. 025. Benny Pickett is Brent Edwards.
Through to the whole line, the final line now.
Thank you. Will.
Greg normally does the stand-up comedy circuit.
Thanks, mate.
In New York.
Maybe you only got one left tomorrow.
One room. That was one room. More school.
That's not going, is it? Oh, you little pain.
You going to show that to school?
You got anything on it?
Hey? No. Had to pull up yourself.
Oh, that's terrible, Michael.
$60.
Hey.
Oh. Will.
Willie. Will, so I can show you at school.
Oh.
Get your hair, bitch.
Your long head loud.
1966 race for Flight Star. No, not sure, could be clunky, I'm not sure, they will go back to the leader. And our leader is 390, Philip Cirilla doing it very well. From Paul Carnivale in second, 07 Johnston, 808 is Lee Herriman, on him is looks like James Campbell. Then you've got young Conkey back in that next spot, at the leader. He's got the pressure right in from Carnivale. Carnivale tries to go in underneath him on the corner. The magic corner off all that because anything can happen there. Great leader still doing it well, young 390. That's Philip Cirilla doing it. The crowd from 346, Paul Carnivale. He gets away on him by 2 or 3 out of that corner. Shannon Johnson sits nicely, but Lee Herriman got the sit on him and going for the sweat. James Campbell's got to be headed from, looks like young Conkey, there could be one in front of him. Leader still looks okay, and Philip Cirilla doing it well. 390 it is from 246. Paul Carnivale went to the inside. But young Philip Cirilla closed the gate again. Paul's got one hell of a job because the gate's been shut every time. 390 it is, and Philip Cirilla doing it well. From 246, Paul Carnivale in second place. Then he's third is 860, Shannon Johnson. On him is 808, young Roy Herriman. On the back door of him, trying to get there is now young Conkey moved up. He's
from the clear. Now they go through to the ambulance corner, and it's Glenn McDonald, Daniel Horlick. Next one is through, Brendan Richardson, Chris McAteer, Darren Rezio, Luke Evans. Jumped there by Mitchell and Elk, John Price, Tony Lawson. Both are charged on now, Richardson starting to come through.
Come on, Brent, come on!
Richardson on the top of the first lap. Worn down Tony Lawson, can he pick up the rest? But Glenn McDonald leads away, Daniel Horlick. Brendan Richardson, the next one, Chris McAteer. There is a bit of work going on as Darren Leslie holds onto the next spot from Luke Hibbert. Brent Stewart there still fighting back with Tony Lawson holding down that final spot. Now there's a late comer, Chris McDonald, Daniel Horlick, Brendan Richardson, Chris McAteer.
Jeez, come on.
Darren Leslie.
Come on.
Oh, I'm hooked up there, boys. There you go, the leader was, he dropped it, so it doesn't mean that our leader now can't. Daniel Horlick, second place, followed by Brendan Richardson. Horlick can jump there, again by Brent Stewart, Chris McAteer, Darren Lindsay, Luke Gibbons. Paul Prudence, Brothers, really flying, and Brent Stewart trying to get on first again. And Tony Lawson, as they come out of it, Bill Glenn McDonald, Daniel Horlick, Brendan Richardson, dropping up the plate, Chris McAteer, then,
and Aaron Plummer down the back of the course. But there's a big move as they come up this short straight, and Bradley taken as Riley Taylor's taken over two spots. Tim Watson leads away from Jamie McGinn. Ron has a party. And there's a big charge as they go through. Whoa, holy moly, it's a change of underwear. But Bradley Taylor holds on as he drops it down another gear. Up the tail in that final spot. But it's still a real move afoot as Tim Watson leads away. Jamie McGinn holding down second spot still with Ron Asapati chasing hard. They're well broken clear as they drop down to 1-3 Hill. Shane Kowalko starting to work through the field. Travis Smithoff dropped off the pace and Aaron Somerville holding down that final pot. Into number 8 they go and up the hill he goes. Tim Watson, Jamie McKim holding down that next spot. Still under a lot of pressure. And there's a passing move as they go start to go up the hill again. And flying through the inside. Looks like Bradley Taylor's going to have another go.
What a shit on the wind.
But it's Tim Watson as they come down the hill. Jamie McKim. Down the inside they come. And there's a lot of work as down the inside. Bradley Taylor trying through. And looks like he might have dropped it. No, he's dropped back about 3 spots over. So Tim Watson goes through. Jamie McKim's the next one. Then we've got Jamie McKim, one of the parties, and Aaron Somerville. Through the stutters for the lay, last time they go. And leading it nicely, Tim Watson. Jamie McKim. There's a passing move there at 5.24. Bill Keenan's come up through the pack. Bacon Tuff come up also. Oh, James Cowell goes on through the inside of Bradley Taylor. And Aaron Meyer now is going to chase hard. But as they come up through the bottom, there's a real charge on Bill Keenan. Oh, and he's dropped it. But he's up and run off the track. But well up in the air there. They wind down now, and it's Tim Watson nicely clear as he comes up through there. Next one to go through will be a charge of Jamie McKim, but he's under a lot of pressure now. As squaring the corner and coming up the outside inside. As Shane Kowalko goes up the hill also, being chased by Bradley Taylor. But don't take it away for this leader, Tim Watson. He's going to take this one out in fine style. Takes it nice and smooth as he comes through the essence for the last time. Looks at the checkered flag and says, this one's all mine. Nice smooth through the corner and takes it out in fine style. Jason Tuff is going to hold out and take out that second spot. Next one to go through will be Jamie McKim.
Probably sitting on the fence. Tell me it's not that coming out.